Everything you learn is just raw information. What you should start doing is seeing yourself as a separate being from anyone else in this room. You, each and every one of you now, I want to go home and put an incorporated after your name in your head. You are now a being, an incorporated. You are incorporated. You are now going to take information and go, ah, I could use that for this and that and that. Don't show your cards to anybody else. Some guy comes along, he sounds like, thinks he sounds better than you. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. But work on your thing, and then you can figure out what makes you you artistically. And then you can access information. When I go into the studio, when I sit in with an artist, I'm accessing information. I'm not accessing, it's like a library. I go, I'm gonna take this out, and this, sort of like being a DJ. This'll work. But not by way of just playing everything. And that's what I wish people could do more. I don't know if you can do it real time. I don't know, maybe this is just the time you get everything and you worry about sort of figuring it out later. But I think it'd be an interesting idea to look at the information, learn it, and then immediately start figuring out how you use it or how you don't use it. You know, drummers overplay, guitar players overplay, singers oversing, and songwriters overwrite. So it's a matter of how you begin to shape. Anybody ever jam, and they jam too much, and they run out of ideas, and they get that itchy feeling on the way home, like they just gave up too much, like they just somehow sort of empty. I played everything, and I saw the end of my own musical existence. I was on the dirt. I was just ended up in the rough, or the golf course. I don't know. That is just a misappropriation of what you know. You've just all of a sudden gotten to the bottom of the trick bag, and there was a hole in it. And you just going, ooh, why did we jam? We jammed on E for an hour. I was in an ensemble class, the great Dennis Montgomery III. I was in an ensemble class yesterday, and the song that we were playing on was a great song. It's On and On by Erykah Badu. You know? See, the women are like, I know this. It's two chords. They're both sort of the one. Just a one chord the whole time, right? Now, here I come into this. I'm like hot shot, hot stepper. I come into the studio. I've played with everybody. And I put on the guitar, and they're playing the song. All right, here we go. And I'm going, all right, I'm comping. And then Dennis says, John, take it. And I'm going, and I'm going, oh, terrible. Well, I don't have it. My guitar playing went away. What happened to my guitar playing? And then something came back to me, and I said, dude, you're just playing over a one. What can you play over that? And I just want you to also stay awake to that. What? Look at the chord arrangement. How am I supposed to solo for 30 seconds or a minute or 90 seconds over a one? I got nothing for that. Nothing. Nobody has anything for that. It's all going to sound weird. It's just screwed up from the get-go. It's a playing on a one. So that's where I want to take you into playing some songs. To sort of keep it all coherent, this is a song that when I wrote it, I knew two things. I knew that I thought it was pretty good. I thought it was great. And I also knew there was never a chance that it could ever make it on the radio or be a hit. Would die on the radio. And I have songs that I know that with as well. While I'm writing, I go, you're going to be a quarterback for this record. Sometimes I go, you're just going to be the kicker. You just come out for the field goal.
Sleep on this tonight. stop this train. I wanna get off and go again. I can't take the speed it's moving in. I know I can, but honestly, won't someone stop this train? To say it, don't wanna see my parents go. I'm one generation's length away from fighting life out on my own. Oh, now stop this train. I wanna get off and go again. Can't take the speed it's moving in. I know I can't, but honestly, won't someone stop this train? Just begun, yeah. Had a talk with my old man, said help me understand. He said turn 68, you ready to go. She ain't, don't stop this train. Don't fall, let it lose the place you're in. Don't think I couldn't ever understand. Oh, I tried. This train. Oh, now once in a while, when it's good, it'll feel like it should. And they're all still around, and they're still safe and sound. And you don't miss a thing till you cry. Driving away in the dark, just singing, stop this train. I wanna get off and go home again. I can't take the speed this thing is moving in. I know I can, cause now I see I'll never stop this train. Never stop this train. I wish I was homeward bound. I wish I was homeward bound. Home, when my thoughts escaping home, when my music's playing home, when my love lies waiting silently, silently for.
Thank you very much. There's information and there's inspiration, and I could not have written that song if I didn't go to Berklee College of Music.